The procurement of a modern combat aircraft is a costly and complex process. So the air force of a small country can easily get into military and political turbulence. Once lost, public confidence is difficult to reestablish. October 9, 1973, the Swiss Federal Council accepts the report of the Chief of General Staff on the future concept of air warfare, which had been requested after the Corsair stalemate. This report clearly establishes the requirement for an air defense fighter. The new aircraft is to protect ground forces and ground attack airplanes against enemy fighters. Under the guidance of the Defense Technology and Procurement Group, or DTPG, the aircraft under consideration are subjected to intensive flight tests. Of special interest, two Tiger F-5Es are flown to Switzerland. Among other things, the test program includes performance verification flights, examination of cavern compatibility, gun firing against fixed ground targets, and instrument approaches to various alpine airfields. Good turning performance, easy operation and maintenance, and an adequate number of aircraft for air defense missions within the financial means available were decisive for the selection of the United States aircraft. In its message of August 27, 1975 to the Federal Assembly, the Federal Council requests a credit of 1.17 billion Swiss francs for the procurement of 72 Tiger fighters. The project was approved by the First Chamber on December 9, 1975, and by the Second Chamber on March 16, 1976.
Gruppenverrüstungsdienst muss die Ablieferung von der Tigerflugzeuge.
DTPG has the task of setting up a delivery schedule for Tiger aircraft, allowing for the Swiss Air Force to receive its first squadron as quickly as possible for training purposes, and of planning for as many aircraft as feasible to be final assembled in Switzerland. As an optimum solution, the first 19 aircraft will be completed at the manufacturer's plant, shipped to Switzerland and reassembled by the Federal Aircraft Factory at Emmen. The remaining 53 aircraft will be delivered to the Federal Aircraft Factory in so-called knockdown ship sets for final assembly. With such a program, we hope to have all 72 Tiger aircraft operational by March 1981.
After extensive preparations, final assembly of 53 Tiger aircraft at the Federal Aircraft Factory Emmen started in spring of 1978. Most of the ship sets, more than 7,000 components per aircraft, reached Switzerland by air freight. The time required for final assembly of a Tiger at Emmen is 8 months. Every 2 weeks, a complete aircraft leaves the assembly line. Let's pick out one of them and follow it through successive stages of production. The electrical wiring leading to various subsystems from the cockpit is collected in cable harness, and for reasons of weight, is reduced to the minimum length necessary. When the fore and aft fuselage are joined, the aircraft begins to take shape. The next important step is the installation of the wing. By means of a dolly and a special lifting device, the wing is carefully positioned. In order to withstand the extremely high loads during subsequent flying operations, the main wing attack bolts have to be tightened to an exactly defined torque value.
What now.
Prior to their installation, the two General Electric engines undergo extensive functional checks in the engine test cell. Not only the final assembly of the aircraft, but also the quality control is part of the Swiss Tiger program. Each system must attain the performance specified by the manufacturer. Otherwise, it will be rejected. The required thrust of a Tiger engine with afterburner is at least 4,960 pounds. After installation of the engine, functional checks of the landing gear hydraulics lowering time, positive locking, and flawless operation of the gear doors are decisive factors. The wheel brakes of the Swiss Tiger have been modified and equipped with a new anti-skid system. On the medium-length runways of our Alpine airfields, minimum braking distances are an absolute necessity. However, test flights have shown that this system, especially on wet runways, does not yet render acceptable results. Mojave Desert, California. Temperature, 100 degrees Fahrenheit in the shade. Rain, in short supply. A water truck of the US Air Force conjures those considerable puddles onto the runway. For once, this is no Fata Morgana, which are normally the result of heavy showers. And another unusual thing, a Swiss Tiger in the sky of California, ready to land at the well-known Edwards Test Base. All important aircraft manufacturers use Edwards as a test site. Northrop is here too, and in cooperation with DTPG specialists, the shortcomings of the Tiger's braking system are to be eliminated for an additional series of tests. Important braking data such as deceleration, wheel rotation, and pedal pressure are immediately transmitted to the test center by telemetry, where they are automatically recorded, so the test engineer can evaluate the results already during the test flight.
Here are the data. 120 knots, we have here eindeutig Ackerplanung.
Cooling fan in position. Time of flight recorded. Windshield clean. Refueling going on. Scenes of an aircraft turnaround as performed in the United States. As soon as the brakes are back to normal operating temperature, the aircraft can be released for a final test, during which the values of a maximum weight landing are measured. DTPG test pilot Bernie Alder at the controls. A maximum weight landing is considered an exceptional or emergency situation. Only if the pilot is forced to land immediately after takeoff due to a technical breakdown, the aircraft with full fuel tanks must be slowed down with its maximum service weight. And even if the brake parachute fails, stopping distances endangering neither the pilot nor the aircraft should still be possible.
Mr. Brennwald, last week DTPG has conducted an extensive test program at Edwards. What were purpose and major points of these tests?
We have conducted two types of performance verification flights. First of all, performance and functioning of the Swiss modifications were checked. These modifications include an improved radar system, an inertial navigation system, anti-skid brakes required for landing on our alpine airfields, specific Swiss oxygen equipment operating with liquid oxygen, and the Swiss tow car, allowing a quick takeoff in case of emergency. In addition, flight performance and handling characteristics were tested, which are not feasible in Switzerland, mainly air combat in a supersonic speed range and at low altitudes, that is, a few hundred meters above ground.
Have these tests confirmed the performance data for the Tiger the Americans have specified?
Practically all systems have performed well or better than specified.
How will these 19 Tigers assembled in the USA be brought to Switzerland?
Various transport possibilities have been examined, such as land transport, shipment by sea, and air freight. For financial reasons, the Galaxy transport has been chosen as the best solution.
The American Transport Galaxy, the world's biggest aircraft. These are superlatives, which Switzerland doesn't offer every day. The impact of almost 300 tons during landing is absorbed by as many as 28 wheels. A crowd of over 50,000 is witnessing this spectacular event. In its belly, this giant of the air carries six complete Tiger fighters, among them two two-seaters, which are urgently needed for pilot training by the Swiss Air Force. Numerous high-ranking foreign and Swiss public figures and officers are seated on the stand of honor.
Members of the crew of the C-5.
But the Galaxy is not the only star of the day. After the crew, which hardly shows the stress of several hours' flight across the Atlantic, has been welcomed, another highlight, the rollout of the first Tiger made in Switzerland. The day ends with a small but exceptional aircraft exhibition featuring Switzerland's showpiece in nostalgia, the good old Junkers 52. And now the Galaxy Monster will soon spit out its load. Crew members and employees of the Federal Aircraft Factory start unloading the valuable freight. The special shipping fixtures are rolled onto a mobile platform loader and then brought to the big workshop. Thanks to the Tiger's simple construction, mating of fuselage and wings takes only a few hours. The following day, all six aircraft are ready for functional checkouts. But let's go back to the Swiss assembly line, where another wing will be installed shortly. In the meantime, our aircraft has advanced to the so-called facting, a systems test, during which all electrical lines are measured and all relays checked. By means of a special computer, short circuits unintentionally made during assembly can be easily localized. Airborne radar and inertial navigation systems are also submitted to a functional check prior to their installation. The lock-on mode, which is important during air combat, can be simulated on the radar scope. The Tiger ejection seat, an indispensable safety feature for the fighter pilot, is of the latest design and contains a survival kit. After installation of the seat, the actual assembly of the aircraft is completed. The Tiger is now ready to get its outer paint coat in the paint shop. The last ground test in the underground firing tunnel. Certification of gun performance. After each gun has fired 50 rounds, the hits marked with color are counted. The dispersion of the two guns must be within specified limits. October 10th, 1978, 6 weeks ahead of time. Another reason for a small celebration. The first Tiger aircraft is delivered to the Swiss Air Force. The factory band, some faces are familiar from the assembly line, musically welcomes the guests. Representatives from the Air Force, the Federal Agency for Military Airfields, the Defense Technology and Procurement Group, and from the Federal Aircraft Factory are obviously pleased with the course the Tiger procurement has taken so far. But also the staff on the lower levels has every reason to be proud of its work, because today we can predict already that the last production aircraft will be delivered on schedule in spring 1981. At that time, the Swiss Air Force will have 4 operational Tiger squadrons.
Nun zum Kampfflugzeug Tiger selbst. Seine primäre Rolle ist klar definiert.
The introduction of the Tiger, whose primary function is clearly defined, will fill a big gap in the Swiss air defense system and enable the Air Force, first, to protect our ground troops effectively against enemy fighter bombers. Second, to improve survival chances of our ground forces. And third, to support our small number of Mirage fighters during general air defense and neutrality protection missions.
Neutralitätsschutzaufgaben zu ergänzen. Der F-5 ist heute und in absehbarer Zukunft
Thanks to its specific qualities and equipment, the F-5 is well suited to fulfill its operational tasks. Our pilots are eager to prove its performance in the Swiss environment. The main tasks of the Swiss Air Force are 1. Aerial reconnaissance with Mirage 3 RS reconnaissance aircraft. 2. Ground attack missions with Hunter fighter bombers. 3. Air defense missions to protect Swiss neutrality and in case of war, mainly with Mirage 3S supersonic fighters. 4. Maintenance of local air superiority for Swiss ground troops and ground attack fighters with Tiger F-5E air defense fighters. These four types of aircraft are the mainstays of the Swiss Air Force. Air Force and anti-aircraft troops are controlled from a direction center. The computer of the Florida radar system furnishes the officers in command with the basic data necessary for flexible but coordinated air combat. How will the Tiger fit into the existing defense strategy, and what are its tasks within the Air Force? The technical data first. Northrop F-5E air defense fighter, 2 engines, 2 20mm cannons, 2 IR guided missiles, extremely maneuverable, maximum speed, Mach 1.6. During peacetime, the Tiger combat aircraft are serviced by members of the Federal Office for Military Airfields. The aircraft lands with a drag chute, which the pilot drops before the plane leaves the runway. A bullseye obviously saves the maintenance man a lot of trouble.
Mr. Leubli, in Switzerland the Tiger will be mainly employed as an air defense fighter. What are the main assets of this aircraft?
First of all, its small silhouette, which makes it difficult to be seen by the enemy, a great advantage in air combat. Then its maneuverability, and last but not least, its state-of-the-art electronic system.
You think our militia pilots can fly this aircraft without difficulties?
There's no doubt about that. Every licensed Swiss pilot will be able to fly the Tiger. How well he will perform in highly demanding tactical air combat situations remains to be seen. We are working on it.
Only experienced military pilots are admitted to the Tiger pilot training, which lasts several months. The goals of transitional training include safe takeoff and landing, mastering of the aircraft's systems and controls over the entire flight envelope. Formal air combat includes basic attack and defensive maneuvers, as well as respective voice terminology. Tactical air combat concentrates on gaining advantages over the enemy aircraft. The third week of training for the pilots of Militia Flying Squadron 19. Today's program, formal air-to-air combat with guns. Special attention will be paid to correct handling of weapons and use of the optical sight. Once the target aircraft has extended the hit indicator equipped sleeve toe target, the Tigers can attack. A direct hit, and the target falls to the ground. During its next mission, the four-ship flight of Squadron 19 from the French-speaking part of Switzerland will perform the so-called anti-noise takeoff for the first time. It is certainly appropriate to repeat this procedure, which later on will become an everyday routine for the pilots. In order to reduce to a minimum the noise disturbance for the civilian population, a special takeoff procedure has been developed for the F-5. Thanks to its high thrust, the Tiger can perform a steep climb right after takeoff and reach an altitude of 1,000 meters over the end of the runway. As a result, there is considerably less noise within the inhabited departure sector. For the impressive demonstration we will now see, the pilot needs maximum concentration and a good sense of flying.
Brake release, Achtung, stop.
Its maneuverability and good turning performance are the Tiger's biggest assets for air combat. During the low-level demonstration turn, flown especially for this film, the safety rules must be strictly observed. Speed, 300 knots. Flaps maneuver. Afterburner on. No sinking is allowed during turns. Impressive scenery. The narrow mountain valley and lake of the Klöntal in the canton of Glarus. Another advantage for air combat, powerful acceleration after the turn.
Ich erwarte das Ziel auf 10 Meilen einlaufend und schalte den Radar da auf Lockon.
Richtig. Das ist der Moment, wo wir im Neutralitätsschutz Patrouillen aufteilen.
Protection of neutrality. The first stage of a possible conflict. Foreign planes are to be kept from entering our airspace.
Identifikationselement.
Gerade in dem Moment führen.
Two pilots and their flight instructor discuss the time sequence of an exercise for the protection of neutrality with subsequent order to land.
Jawohl.
Und Sicherungselement ist auf der optimalen Kanonenschussdistanz hinter dem Ziel.
Such exercises for the protection of neutrality are part of tactical air combat training. Approach, identification, and directions to land are carried out according to an internationally defined scenario. The intercept director in the Air Defense Control Center leads the Tiger to the target detected by radar.
Distanz 1-2, livello 3-0.
5 capito, avviso contact, 60 grande.
As soon as visual contact is established, the wingman positions himself within firing range behind the invader. At the same time, the pilot of the other Tiger closes in and identifies type, tail number, and national markings of the foreign aircraft.
Capito, ordine di manella.
5 capito.
Wing shaking and gear down are signals ordering a landing. The hunter pilot correctly obeys the orders and seems to resign himself to the unpleasant situation. But watch out. The nearby mountain saddle may tempt him to escape. Yet the sight camera film confirms the fatal consequences such a reckless maneuver would have during actual combat. The pilots of the 11th Squadron, a professional formation of the Swiss Air Force, have successfully concluded their transitional training. During an additional 2 weeks training course working together with the assigned ground personnel on a tactical airfield, the operational readiness of a Swiss Tiger squadron will be proven. At the cavern entrance, identity check. A tactical airfield, which is run by an airbase group with its complex, mostly underground installations. Several hundred specialists are working in various areas. The following film sequences, which are released for public viewing for the first time, give an interesting insight into the operation and organization of a Swiss tactical air base. Moving aircraft within the cavern. The reinforced hoisting points allow all necessary crane maneuvers. Tire checks are made while the aircraft are hoisted. Because of the rather limited space, the crane operator has to be particularly careful when the aircraft is being rotated. For the maintenance company, repairs such as welding and the replacement of worn tires are part of the everyday routine. In the pilot briefing room, which is large enough for two squadrons, the intelligence officer informs the crews about the forthcoming mission.
Der findliche Vorstoß wird wahrscheinlich begleitet durch massiven Einsatz von Erdkampfflugzeugen.
Enemy flying formations in the upcoming exercise, played by Hunter fighter bombers and Mirage escort fighters, are to be kept from entering our operational area.
Fertig. Darf ich dem Geschwaderführer jetzt das Wort erteilen?
It is the intention of the wing commander to maintain local air superiority in the patrol area, taking into account yesterday's experience. Now, both four-ship flights will be briefed separately. After moving the aircraft to their proper positions, mechanics can start pre-flight checks. Engine oil checked. Rotor vanes, no damage. Air defense mission for the pilots of a four-ship flight. The major points of the flight leader's briefing are flight plan, inputs to the navigation computer, and tactics for the surveillance of the airspace. In addition, every pilot must be informed about the weapons carried. Since the following mission is an exercise, only dummy rounds are loaded for safety reasons. Their weight and handling correspond to tactical ammunition.
Due Petrolberechnung.
Kamini 20 Bingo 16.
Kamini and Bingo, two important values for fuel calculation. When they are reached, the pilots must return from the combat area. At the end of the briefing, the pilots are informed about the meteorological situation in the operational area and about existing dangerous and prohibited zones. An energetic pull on the charging handle and the armament mechanics' work is done. In the control room, the air traffic control officer receives the flight plan.
Die Anflugzeit müssen wir hier noch zurückversetzen um 10 Minuten auf 17.30 und das gibt die Anflug bei Wechsel.
17.30, das ist gut.
Danke schön.
A glass door nearby. The flight operations officer acts as liaison officer between the wing and the maintenance companies. In the direction center, all activities on the airbase are supervised. The central public address system is also operated from here. Life on an airbase is varied, a continuous coming and going, constant shifting of the center of activities. A typical example. On their way to a demanding flight mission, The pilots meet a group of armament mechanics going to the canteen. By the time the pilots take over the aircraft, the briefing must be completed. The crew chief reports to the pilot that the aircraft serviced by his crew is ready for takeoff. Strapping in and checks together with the ground crew must be carried out in a calm and thorough way. As soon as the enormous armored doors are open, the aircraft can move out. Maximum concentration for the tractor driver. Assisted by a pointer, he steers accurately along the lines marked on the ground. This is the only way to guarantee that the aircraft can't touch anywhere. For technical reasons, the engines have to be started on specially prepared aprons just outside the cavern. The work is to be performed efficiently and in an exactly defined order. Start up the air starter. Park the first plane. The following aircraft goes to the other side. Connect the air tube. Wait for the pilot signal. Engine start. Auxiliary air intake doors open. Remove chocks. Check controls. Don't forget pitot tube sleeve. Drive the tractor away, and the aircraft are ready for takeoff.
Tiger 49er, runway 29er.
Taxi to the end of the runway. This is the last moment the pilot can concentrate on the imminent mission. But also for us who will witness the flight from takeoff to landing, increased attention is advisable. The breathtaking flight sequences and hectic air combat which air defense fighters often have to engage in requires split-second decisions. The takeoff, mere routine, afterburner turned on, time interval to the following patrol, 10 seconds. Steep takeoff, join up of the four-ship flight. On the outward flight, the expected bad weather zone. Change of flight path. Detour, behind schedule. Increase speed. The Air Defense Direction Center is notified. The local air superiority sector is reached. Diapoli, enemy aircraft, at a distance of 90 kilometers from the Tiger. Break into two patrols and entering a defensive patrol pattern. Hunters, enemy fighter bombers, now at 70 kilometers. The first and second Tigers on the northern defense patrol break away to the west. Mirages, enemy fighter planes, air cover for the hunters. Tigers 3 and 4 in the southern sector, 180 turn towards the east. The hunters are breaking away to the left, distance to the Tigers, 40 kilometers. Search the airspace and report positions. The Mirages are only 20 kilometers away. Tigers 1 and 2 leave ground cover. Four hunters, practically within sight. Tiger 1 should see them. There. Radar lock on and enemy coverage. Simulated firing of guided missiles. Hard turn of the hunters. Tiger 1 pulls up. 2 stays behind. A desperate situation for the ground attack airplanes. Watch out! The escort fighters are here. A Mirage is attacking Tiger II, which has to break off the pursuit of the hunters and repel the Mirage attack. Tiger I observes the action from above and enters the combat from behind, the beginning of a fierce air battle.
Bingo. Okay, bambini, finito da me.
The air combat is over. The four-ship flight returns to base. It would be too early to judge the mission now. First, the sight camera film and the recorded radio transmissions have to be analyzed. But we can certainly say that the training of Swiss military pilots is as realistic as possible. The following instrument flight is no exception to this rule.
Tiger 2-0, turn left, heading 190.
Left 190 and break speed set at 4-0.
Tiger 2-0, to short 40 cent.
Tiger 2-0, gear down. And descend at 2-0 meters. Position altitude 0-9, confirm altitude.
Position 0-9, Tiger 2-0.
Tiger 2-0, position you read. Loud and clear to. Do not acknowledge further instructions. Continue your descent at 2-0 meters.
185, you're heading. Liar miles, complete down.
1-0 meters above glide pass. Turn right 5 degrees, heading 190.
190, you're heading. Going below glide pass.
Slightly left of center line. Decision altitude, torque down completed, out.
Night landing in elements and trail. A difficult maneuver at the end of the mission. Tigris Helveticus, not the latest in technology, but with good air combat performance and the thorough training of pilots and maintenance personnel, the Tiger certainly adds to the fighting power of our Air Force, and the price any enemy will have to pay for the conquest of Swiss airspace has been increased considerably with the employment of this new air defense fighter.